Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion React Dropdown List using the Create React App command. I will also show you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding list and remote data, and customizing pop-up height and width. Let me show you the application creation process. First, I create the app using the Create React App toolchain and use VS Code as the editor, and show the output in the Chrome browser. Now, I create a new application in command prompt using the npx create react app command and provide the app name MyReactApp. I set the script version to template TypeScript. Next, navigate to the desired location and run this example using the npm start command. Now, I can edit the app.tsx page to show the drop-down list. Next, I open the project in VS Code and remove the default code snippets from the app.tsx file and the styles from the app.css file, and import the material theme styles to apply them to the drop-down list. Then, I install the drop-down list package using the command npm install syncfusion ej2 react dropdowns. To start using the dropdown list component, I import it from the ej2 react dropdowns package and include the dropdown list component tag. Add a few styles to align the dropdown list component. Let's see the output now. See, the dropdown list is rendered. And you can notice, no records are displayed in it. Data can be bound to the drop-down list using the DataSource property. I assign the array of string values, such as badminton, cricket, football, golf, and tennis. While binding the data, I also need to map the text and value fields to the drop-down list fields. For this array of simple data, both text and value fields will be considered the same. Let me run this application. Look now, when the drop-down list icon is clicked, the array data will be listed. And I can select any data. I can also bind a JSON array to the drop-down list. I will define a JSON object, naming it sports data. Then I define the object values with two fields, ID and game. I will assign this JSON object to the data source property. Then I need to map the JSON object fields to the value and text fields of the drop-down list using the fields property. Here, I map the ID to the value field and game to the text field. See here, the drop-down list is rendered based on a JSON object. To bind remote data, I use the Syncfusion Data Manager. I import the data manager from the namespace Syncfusion EJ2 data. Then, I declare the variable remote data and create an instance of the data manager to provide the service endpoint URL using the URL property. I assign the remote data link. To make the server understand the request and process the response, we need to specify the adapter type. You can refer to the different adapter types in the UG link provided in the description below. Here I use the Web API adapter. Import it from the EJ2 data package and use it in the adapter. Then enable the cross-domain option. I assign this variable to the data source property. Then map the first name and employee ID field from remote data to the text and value fields in the drop-down list. Declare another variable, data query, and create an instance of the query to specify the field name to fetch from the remote data. Assign this to the query property in the drop-down list. Check now, the drop-down list is rendered with the remote data. Finally, let's see how to set custom values in the pop-up height and width. By default, pop-up width adjusts to drop-down list input element width and height set to 300 pixels. I include pop-up height property and set a custom value. And include pop-up width property and set custom value. See now, the pop-up height and width have been customized. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to configure the Syncfusion React dropdown list using the Create React App command. I also showed you how to configure a few of the control's basic features, like binding list and remote data, and customizing pop-up height and width. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.